People have asked me why it is that anyone would ever get involved in such a crazy cult as Scientology, and I want to take a minute to talk about this. Some people have even left fairly inflammatory comments about how stupid or ignorant or insane anyone would have to be to go anywhere near Scientology. The point they almost universally miss is that no one ever just shows up and knowingly joins a cult. Let's be a little bit more reasonable and look at the real reasons that anyone would get into this. People have mental and emotional needs that are not always met by family or friends, or even trained professionals. No one has a perfect life, and when you're looking for answers and can't find them, you may turn to some pretty unusual places to get them. You walk into a Scientology organization, and you're surrounded by bright, shiny people who tell you with certainty that they completely understand your situation, and they know exactly what you need to do to resolve whatever issue it is that you want to handle. Sometimes you don't even know when you walk in there what it is that you are having trouble with. You just know that something in your life is not the way you want it to be. I can't imagine that anyone watching this doesn't understand what I'm talking about. The initial conversations with Scientologists are usually calm, very friendly, and very understanding. When someone needs help, they have to trust someone. And when they trust Scientologists, they're told that the answers to their problems were totally solved by L. Ron Hubbard through scientific means, and that his solutions have universal workability. Even though none of what they're saying is true, it all sounds great. Whether the problem is interpersonal communications, problems with a marriage, job performance, anxiety, a chronic, unexplainable medical condition, or just a general depression, there is some solution that Scientology can offer which promises to change everything for the better. That is the hook that reels people in who maybe should have known better. I've talked about hindsight bias before on my blog. It's easy to see your mistakes when you look into the past and see all the consequences of your actions. It's not so easy when those consequences are in the future and you haven't lived them yet. Similarly, once someone's been involved for a while and some of the trickery and abuses start becoming more noticeable, why do they stay? Well, this is the core issue of the documentary, the prison of belief, and it's what Lawrence Wright and Alex Gibney spend 2 hours explaining. The way they do this is quite genius. They get many different people to express the similarities and the differences of their own experiences. There's no place for judgment here, and the film should finally set the record straight that almost anyone can fall for this. Intelligence has nothing to do with it. I suppose there are some people who will see this and walk out thinking that it could never happen to them, not realizing that to some degree it already has, with their own religion, political party, or other affiliation. This film is about a lot more than Scientology, and to anyone who cares to look, they will see that the lessons to be learned from it apply to many more things than just the belief system of Scientology.